we are going to study about Ramapitkas. So Ramapitkas was late Miocene epoch fossils which at first discovered by Pilgrim. In 1910 from Shivalik region of India. So you can write your introduction. Ramapitkas was late Miocene epoch fossils which at first discovered by Miocene epoch fossils which at first discovered by Pilgrim in 1910 from Shivalik region of India. From Shivalik region of India he named them Ramapitkas. Named them Ramapitkas. After that, in 1934, G. Lewis had discovered fossils of Ramapitkas from Shivalik region of India. Discovered fossils of Ramapitkas from Shivalik region of India. Then in 1961 L.S. Billicke has discovered fossils of Ramapitkas from Fort Turner of Kenya and named them Kenyapithecus. Yeah, and name them Kenyapithecus. In 1972, one Quinswald has discovered fossils of Ramapitkas from Greece. And they call them Greekopithecus. Pithecus. In 1975, Crete Joey has discovered fossils of Ramapitkas from Rudamba. Rudamba Hill of Hungary and they call them Rudamba with us. Therefore, fossils of Ramapithecus were found from various parts of India, Pakistan, China, Turkey, Kenya, Greek, Hungary, etc. So Ramapithecus was lived in Old World. Ramapithecus was lived in Old World in late Miocene. In late Miocene, epoch, right? But this important points or facts you have write when question ask on Ramapithecus to write on full length question, not in short answer question. In short answer question, you have only write first fossils of Ramapithecus was discovered by Pilgrim in 1910 from Shivalik region of India, and after that fossils of Ramapithecus were found from various parts of world world. Right? Short notes mean aapko jyada nahi likhna. Then physical feature. So basically, we found fossils of Ramapithecus related to their jaw and teeth mainly. So most of their physical feature which we are going to write related to their jaw and teeth. So first important thing is that dental arcade. Is V-shaped. Second, diastema was not present. Right? Diastema is the feature of ape, and that is not present in Ramapithecus, means that is the feature of human. Third, their incisor was smaller than ape. Next, canine was also smaller than ape. And next, first premolar was semi-sectoral. Semi-sectoral. And sectoral is the feature of ape. Right? ratio of canine and premolar and molar and premolar, we are as similar to man.
Dobar premolar.
Ratio of canine and premolar. The size ratio of canine and premolar and size ratio of premolar and molar are as similar to man. Molar. Molar and premolar. Right? Next, size order of molar teeth, where 1, 2, 3 means 1 greater than 2, 2 greater than 3. So this is the human feature. There are 3 molar teeth. So first molar teeth is larger and third molar teeth is smaller. This is human like feature. Right. Next, thick enamel on their teeth. Thick enamel on their teeth. Or next, their upper jaw is smaller and in lower jaw there was less prognathism than ape. Prognathism than ape. So this is the physical feature of Ramapithecus. Right? Then we have to write about their phylogenetic position. Phylogenetic position. And in phylogenetic position, there are disputes among paleoanthropologists. There are disputes among paleoanthropologists for the determination of phylogenetic position of Ramapithecus. Elvin Simon said that Ramapithecus was ancestor of human because their dental arcade or dental pattern we are continuously evolve in human direction their jaw was also smaller so Ramapithecus was ancestor of Australopithecus so Ramapithecus was ancestor of Australopithecus while David Pilgrim he said that Ramapithecus has both ape and human like feature ape and human like feature so Ramapithecus was ancestor of both ape and man but he was first ape like human fossils ancestor by which human evolved Alan Wilson and Serich Alan Wilson and Serich had done bioprotein synthesis to fossils of Ramapithecus and on the basis of protein synthesis they said that Ramapithecus was ancestor of orangutan not ancestor of human cloning has also said that cloning Ramapithecus was not ancestor of man because he was the ancestor of orangutan Ramapithecus was ancestor of orangutan not ancestor of man hai na paragraph change therefore most of anthropologists have believed that Ramapithecus was ancestor of man, but many anthropologists think that Ramapithecus was Ramapithecus was ancestor of orangutan or ape or orangutan or ape. Because we got mainly teeth and jaw related fossils of Ramapithecus, jaw. We have not found whole fossils of Ramapithecus. Therefore, phylogenetic position of Ramapithecus is not absolutely clear. So this is Ramapithecus, right?